točke na točko je tako ali zanimiva pokrajina.
Properly treat them at the same time. In order to provide greatest good for the greatest number, in despite of the shortage of resources, we apply triage criteria. And in the avalanche rescue part of it, they're called remote reverse triage criteria. So we want to focus on those ones who have a high likelihood of survival, and it only takes a little chance to, a little effort to get them out. So shallow burial depths, no trees, no crevasses, no high cliffs, or vital data from these transceivers who are capable to provide vital data. These are all the criteria we look for, because these are the patients. They have a better chance of survival, and it takes us less time to get them out.
And is it frequently the case when things go out that there are not enough resources, that there are more victims than resources?
This has usually to do how the rescue organization is built up. You imagine the helicopter flies in, the first helicopter, usually there are two, three rescuers. So at the very beginning, often you are in reverse triage because you have very limited resources compared to the problem on site. However, as the rescue organization starts to build up and more resources arrive, on ground or by air, you suddenly start to be at the point where there are the same amount of rescuers than buried subjects, or even more rescuers than people in need. And then you go towards positive triage, which allows you to focus then as well on those ones which you had to postpone prior to that. For example, somebody who's particularly deep, which we couldn't take out at the very beginning. But now, when we have much more rescues than buried subjects, of course, we immediately start shoveling there as well.
That's fantastic.